fucking did.
Sure. She benefactor, nigga. I'm coming up.
Come on up, nigga. It's open.
You know, my pleasure of living demands that I have a good-looking woman. That I'm with a good-looking woman. I couldn't go out with a woman old enough to be my wife.
Oh, D!
Look at you and your free ass.
What's up, man?
Hey, come here, no, boy. Give me a motherfucking hug.
I didn't know you were coming by.
Yeah, my nigga.
Good looking out, man. I don't know what to say, man. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Uh-huh. Who was there for your ass,
you
huh?
Was there
who?
For you.
Who?
You,
who?
Nigga, you.
You goddamn right, see? That's how that shit works. You get your ass in trouble, I get your ass out. That's my motherfucking job. And I don't mind telling you, nigga, it's steady work.
Hey, look here, man. I'm still scared to the motherfucker OD. They talking like they serious as hell. Give me time for that machine gun shit.
Oh, come on, man. They just trying to put a fright in your ass.
If that's what they doing, they done did it.
How old is that machine gun shit, huh?
About 3 years.
3 years? Come on, man. That's an old crime, man. They ain't got room in the joint for all these niggas out here killing people now. How they gonna find room for you?
Ain't what they telling me.
That's why they call it fucking with you. And let me tell you how we gonna retaliate, all right? Tomorrow, I'm gonna pick you up, take you over to Century City, introduce you to my lawyer. And let me tell you something about my lawyer. This brother's name is Stassen Goins, and this nigga is a junkyard dog. He my own personal Johnny Cochran. Matter of fact, he kicked Johnny Cochran's ass. And like Johnny Cochran, this nigga hate cops. I'm serious, man. He lived to fuck with the police. Now, as a favor, I had him look at your case. And he said, you ain't got shit to worry about. They just fucking with you. So we gonna sick the junkyard dog on the ass and make him stop fucking with you.
Huh? Good looking out, man. Huh? Good looking out. Come on in, man.
No, come on, man.
Let's celebrate.
Look here. I'm really supposed to be somewhere. Matter of fact, I was kind of hoping you could run with me.
What you mean?
You know, man, I hate to be the kind of nigga that do a nigga a favor and then, bam, hit the nigga up for a favor in return, but I got to be that kind of nigga.
What? What you want?
I need a favor, nigga.
That requires me to go out tonight?
Just a bit.
Oh, man, I wasn't planning on going no place tonight, man. It is late as hell, man. I'm home, I'm high, man. Come on.
And why are you home, huh? You home because I spent $10,000 to get your ass home. And look, I got a little problem, all right? I need some help. You can help me out. Now, come on, go on in the house, throw some shit on. Come on, let's walk out to the car with you. Come on.
Ready, man. What's the problem?
It ain't no problem, man. It's more like a situation. You remember them 3M60 machine guns I sold last year at the five I got?
Yeah.
I'm gonna sell the other two tonight. There's this group of Koreans over in Koreatown starting this little neighborhood watch thing, and they need some weapons so they can show the neighborhood niggas they mean business. Now, I'm gonna sell them the other two machine guns, all right? Problem is, I ain't never done business with these Koreans before. Now, I ain't worried, because by and large, Asians are very dependable. You know, they don't want no trouble. And you might argue with them about price and shit, but you ain't got to worry about them shooting in the back, you know what I'm saying? But I got me a rule. Never do business with people you ain't never done business with before without backup. And that's why I need you. Backup. Now, look, all you got to do is lay in here and hold on to this motherfucker, all right? I'm gonna tell him I'm going in the trunk to show him the goods. When I open the trunk, you pop up and rack this motherfucker.
Man, fuck that shit. I ain't finna shoot nobody.
I ain't saying nothing about you shooting nobody. All you gotta do is hold on to it. They'll get the idea.
Man, you must be out of your fucking mind if you think I'm finna get in this dirty-ass trunk.
We ain't going nowhere but to Koreatown, man. You ain't gonna be in here no more than 10 minutes.
Man, I ain't riding in no goddamn trunk for no minute, man. Why I can't ride up front with you?
You can't ride up front with me. The surprise element is 90% of it.
I'm sorry, man, but I ain't getting no goddamn trunk.
I can't believe you do me like this.
Do you like what, man? I just ain't climbing in no goddamn dirty-ass trunk, man. I got a problem with small places, no.
Well, I got a problem with spending $10,000 on ungrateful peanut-head niggas to get them out of jail, but I did it. And how small was that jail cell, motherfucker?
Look, man, I know I owe you. You got to bring all
this up. If you owe me, then get your ass in this trunk.
Man, I want to help you, but I won't be locked in no goddamn trunk or no car.
You think I want to spend $10,000 on your ass, huh?
Man, I know
you. Do
you
think I wanted to spend $10,000 on your ass?
Of course you didn't, man, but you, nigga, get in the trunk.
But that's the only way I could help you, right? So that's what I did. Now, look, man, all I'm asking you to do is get in the trunk, hold this fucking shotgun, and point it at these booty heads when I open it.
You catch your nigga off guard with this shit.
Look here, look here, look here. I tell you what. When we get through fucking with these Koreans, me and you go to Roscoe Chicken and Waffle on me. Think about it now. That scold special, smothered in gravy and onions, side of red beans and rice, some greens. That's some good eating.
Man. Exactly how long I gotta be in this motherfucker? Hey, you said 10 minutes.
Hey, motherfucker, you like to hit my goddamn head! You ponytail wearing motherfucker! Hell wrong with you!
Do a nigga a favor, gotta do it.